Hi, Stanley here. Today, I'll be going over swapping filament on the HS3. The first step is to preheat the nozzle. On the front screen, navigate to temperature and select the material currently loaded in the machine. In this case, it's PETG. Once the hotend is preheated, navigate to the move menu and select unload. The printhead will now purge the hotend before releasing the filament. Moving to the top of the machine, lift up the elbow to finish unloading the printhead. Next, we'll remove the old PETG spool. Before opening the dry box, check the humidity indicator. If it displays more than 10% relative humidity, you'll need to replace the desiccant. There's a convenient ejection lever at the bottom of the box that you can simply pull on to remove the spool. Load in a fresh spool and feed the filament through the tapered entry port until it reaches the end of the filament track elbow. Close the lid and secure it with a quarter turn fastener. If you are swapping filaments with different print temperatures, such as PETG and nylon or vice versa, you will need to purge the hot end. On the front screen, preheat the nozzle to the temperature required for the new material. In this case, it's CF nylon. Wrap a 7mm socket and remove the nozzle from the hot end. Keep track of the filament it has been printing. In this case, it's PETG. Lift up the filament elbow and feed the new filament into the printhead. Give it a good push to ensure it reaches the end. On the front screen, navigate to move and select the load macro. Keep an eye on the filament at the top of the printhead to make sure it's advancing properly. If there's no movement, gently push the filament. After a few seconds, material will be purged from the hot end. Reselect the load macro on the front screen one more time to perform a second purge sequence. If you examine the purged material, you can see that the small amount of PETG left in the hot end from the previous spool has been pushed out by the new nylon material. PETG traces at nylon temperatures can cause nozzle jams, so it's really important to fully purge the hot end and remove any remnants of the old filament. Now we can reinstall the nozzle using a torque wrench and tighten it to 5.6 Nm. Make sure to use a new nozzle or a nozzle that has only been used with the current material to prevent cross-contamination. The machine is now ready for printing. As a tip, if you frequently swap filaments, keep track of your nozzle's material to avoid burning through new nozzles.